Can everybody please have their seats? We're ready to start the council meeting. First of all, I would like to thank everyone for being here this evening. This is the June 4th City Council meeting. We're going to start the council meeting off with something a little different. I'm going to ask for a moment of silence. We've lost two members of our community that have been very active and supportive of this community, one being Donna Alonzo Vaughn, who was the superintendent of the Salinas Elementary School District, and Roy Diaz, one of our surviving members of the Bataan Death March. So if I can have a moment of silence, please. Thank you. Now I would like the city clerk to call roll call, please.
Councilmember Barrera.
Here.
Councilmember Castañeda. Councilmember Craig.
Here.
Councilmember De La Rosa.
Here.
Councilmember Lutz.
Here.
Councilmember McShane.
Yes.
Mayor Gunter.
Yes. We will now do the Pledge of Allegiance. I'm going to have Councilwoman Craig's grandmother lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, along with Councilwoman Craig.
If I may, Mr. Mayor, just very briefly, I would love to speak. Oh, everybody's standing. Okay. I just want to note, my wonderful grandmother is 93 years old. She's here from Palm Desert. She is the woman I strive to become. She is a pretty dynamic young lady, and my dad is escorting her, Jeff Craig. Just want you to know, Grammy, I love you very much, and I'm very, very proud to be your granddaughter. And thank you for coming to Salinas to see me in a city council meeting. So I'm going to step down. I'm going to step down, and we can start it together.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have a couple of special introductions tonight. We have a intern that is working with the assistant city manager, one of our college graduates, Jarrett Train, who is here this evening with us. We also have two students from the Alisal High School District who are their top students. One wants to specialize in pediatric physical therapy, and one is interested in psychology, so coming to this meeting may become quite the lesson in that. That's Lisbeth and Montserrat from the Alisal High School. Thank you all for being here this evening. Okay, if I could have members from Relay for Life step up, I'd like to read a proclamation regarding them. As everyone knows, this is the weekend for Relay for Life. And this, everybody in this room has been affected by someone, relative, friend, men, women, doesn't have any race, cancer reaches out to everyone. So, whereas the American Cancer Society Relay for Life is a changing event that gives everyone across the globe a chance to celebrate the lives of people who have battled cancer and remember loved ones lost, and whereas each year more than 4 million people and more than 52,000 communities in the United States gather to take part in a global phenomenon to raise much funds and cancer awareness, and whereas the goal of Relay for Life is to create a world where more people survive cancer so they can celebrate another birthday, and whereas the American Cancer Society Relay for Life celebrates survivors and caregivers at relay events, honor and applaud as proof that cancer can be defeated. Now, therefore, I, Joe Gunter, on the behalf of the Salinas City Council, recognize the immense effort of all participants in the American Cancer Society Relay for Life, of Salinas to help create a world with more birthdays, dated this fourth day of June, 2013. So you'd like to come up and, or would you like to say a few words?
Oh, yes, if you don't mind.
I don't mind a
bit. We'd like to introduce ourselves. My name is Nicole Zardo, and I am the event chair for the Salinas Relay.
My name is Molly Briseño, and I'm also an event chair for this year in Salinas.
And my name is Margaret Neroyan, and I'm the third event chair.
Okay. It's a big event. And we'd like to invite you all to our event this weekend. It starts at 10 a.m. on Saturday, and it goes until 10 a.m. on Sunday. It's a 24-hour walking event. You do not have to walk the entire time, but we'd love for you to come out and support us. 100% of the fundraising done on site goes to the American Cancer Society and Relay for Life of Salinas. And we are the second largest in California, so if you have not visited us, you should. Sports Complex.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Good luck this weekend.
Thank you.
You're welcome. See you Saturday. Now is the time designated for City of Champions. Councilmember Barrera.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And congratulations to the ladies for Relay for Life. I think it's a great event. I'm going to ask the folks from Poder Popular if they could come to the podium. All the folks that are here from Poder Popular. For those of you that are not aware of what Poder Popular is, this is a group of volunteers that now for several years, under the leadership of the center, I drew a blank here. Mr. Ted, can you tell me the Center for
Community Advocacy?
Thank you, sir. The Center for Community Advocacy has taken this project on, and these folks are residents of the Roosevelt townhouses where they have improved their neighborhoods. They've improved La Paz Park. They've done a lot of hard work, and they've made it a safer place for all the residents that live there. And this evening, it gives me great pleasure, along with Councilmember De La Rosa here, Poder Popular of Salinas, for their work in helping improve the health and well-being of farmers, their families, and the communities where they reside, through leadership development and the formation of alliances and strategies. So on behalf of the mayor and the city council, we want to thank you for the thousands of hours, not only yourselves, but several of the community people that have given to the city of Salinas. So today we thank you and keep up doing a great job. And before I call your names, would somebody like to say something on behalf of Poder Popular?
I want to say thanks. Thanks to the council. Thanks to the, you have amazing staff right behind you. Thanks to, we can make our vision a reality without your support. Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Buenas tardes.
Good afternoon.
Lo siento, voy a necesitar que me interpreten, por favor.
I apologize, I will be needing interpretation.
Mi inglés está en proceso todavía de evolución.
I'm still, my English is in that evolution process.
Buenas tardes, señores autoridades. Buenas tardes al público en general.
Good afternoon to the authorities and to the public in general.
Nosotros somos familias que vivimos en el este de Salinas. Y estamos trabajando en favor de nuestra comunidad en forma voluntaria.
We're a group of families that live in Salinas area, and we're working to improve the area where we live.
Quiero darle las gracias por el reconocimiento al trabajo y al esfuerzo que hemos realizado en forma conjunta.
I want to thank you for all, I want to thank you and thanks for the support of the work that we've done together.
Tenemos contacto con las autoridades que son ustedes.
We have the contact or the connection with the authorities that is you.
Con la policía.
The police department.
Y los pobladores del este de Salinas para ver las propuestas que tienen en el mejoramiento y desarrollo de su comunidad.
And the community in East Salinas and their proposals, the proposals that they have for the betterment of their community.
Nos sentimos contentos por el reconocimiento y quiero decirles algo muy sincero.
We're really happy for this recognition and I want to share something that comes from my more sincere feelings.
Sí, esperábamos con muchas ganas este reconocimiento.
We were actually hoping for this recognition.
Es muy importante para nosotros porque nos sirve de estímulo para seguir trabajando, para seguir fortaleciendo los vínculos de trabajo y de amistad.
It's very important for us because it's a motivation for us to keep working forward, and it also has strengthened our connection with you.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you. And now on behalf of the mayor and city council, we're going to give the certificate to Mr. Jorge Salazar. If you can come here, please. Ulises Foronda y José Jesús Rodríguez. Gracias, Ulises. Gracias, Jesús. Gracias. Y llévate esto, por favor. Gracias.
Now I'll go to Councilwoman De La Rosa.
Good afternoon to all of you. It gives me a great honor to recognize an outstanding woman of Salinas and Monterey County. And I just want to say that when I think of a loving mother, Margaret DeRigo, I think of you. I see you with your children, and as a woman and a mother, they're your life. I can see that. Also, when I think of a mentor for other women, I think of Margaret. Great model for the women in ag. And you have such a big heart. I'm emotional because I'm just thinking of, as a woman, you give of your time. And most of all, she gives of her money to help organizations. And a lot of you may know that are here her friends, that are also, I see, a lot of other outstanding women of Salinas here this afternoon. But Margaret has given a large amount of money to the Special Needs Park, Tatum's Garden. And again, Margaret, thank you. Thank you. Those children, all the children of Salinas, thank you. Thank you for having a big heart. And I would like Margaret to come up now to the podium and her children, her beautiful voice. And Margaret, because I know everything that you've been involved in the past, in numerous boards, and all the things that you're involved in with now, but I just found out that you're going to be a speaker, right? You're going to speak at the United Fresh. You're going to speak on women in produce, inspiring the next generation. Can you mention a little bit of that?
to us?
Sure, I'd be happy to. Thank you so much, Gloria, and the audience and the council and our mayor. Actually, I was asked to speak. It was about a week and a half ago on just helping inspire women in the ag industry to continue the fight, to work hard, and to stay in our industry. It's definitely a man's world, but it's changing too, and there's great opportunities for women. So I really spoke about my 22 years in the produce business and then my transformation from a family business to Taylor Farms, and I'm grateful to have that opportunity to work for a fabulous employer in Monterey County that does so much for this community. So it's truly an honor. And so I really just kind of talked about my journey and encouraged them to, you know, push forward and keep working hard, and their efforts will be recognized.
Great. So can you mention some of the boards that you're sitting on right now?
Sure. I just actually was chairwoman of the Grower Shipper Association Board, retired last week, and I'm working now on the Old Town Association Board and their foundation, and also the Grower Shipper Foundation. I just chaired the United Way campaign for Monterey County, which we, I believe, hit our goal. If not, we're really close. So we did a great job engaging the community. I've been recently a member of CASP, and I've been working on their strategic work plan, which to me is very meaningful. We need to end the violence in the city, and I think to attract good businesses to the city, it's very important that we're all at the table, and ag and business need to be represented. So mm-hmm. I kind of wore two hats at that capacity, and the list kind of goes on and on, but those are some of my favorites. And Hartnell, I've retired from Hartnell, but I'll probably go back in another year because I love the work there with the students, and I believe that education's our solution to poverty and oppression and some of the things that we fight in the city. So I'm very active in that as well.
Great. So again, Margaret, on behalf of myself, the mayor, and the entire city council, thank you, and may God bless you. And thank you for everything that you do.
Thank you very much, Gloria.
Now I'll go to my left to Councilwoman Lutz.
Well, the people that I want to recognize today really fit into the definition of City of Champions are people who are advocates for the city. They're advocates for literacy, and they're advocates for children. The Friends of the Salinas Public Library, or FOSPL, have developed and fostered a real strong working relationship with the city, and it just gives me such great pleasure to recognize them for all the hard work that they've done for the past 50 years. I understand that some of the members, Marvin Wolf, I don't think he's here, but he's been with the FOSPL for nearly 50 years. We've just got some incredible resources in FOSPL that, to me, it's just amazing. Angie, who runs the bookstore that raises money for the libraries, Liz, doing the posters and the banners, Mary Alicia, all the grants that you've brought to this community, Thad, our treasurer, your treasurer extraordinaire, and of course Ken Allen, your president, who's feisty and really making waves, all in the interest of literacy and making this community a better place. This is a community of letters. We are the recipients of the great history and heritage that John Steinbeck leaves us. And so I wanted to take a moment to thank each and every one of you on FOSPL. And Ken, I don't really know all that you do and all that your group does, so I'd like to invite you to come up, talk a little bit about what you each do, and then ask anybody who's a member of FOSPL to please come up and be acknowledged.
Councilmember Lutz, Mr. Mayor, City Council members, and our public, what is it that we do? First of all, it's an honor to be standing in front of you this afternoon and to be recognized, not for myself, but for the organization that we serve. FOSPL is not only a community, it is a city. It is Friends of the Salinas Public Library. Three libraries, growing libraries that need to grow more. Education, communication, understanding, anything that has to do with society's development starts and begins with education and libraries, but then I'm preaching to the choir. If I was to stay here and tell you all the things that we are doing, we would be here for another half an hour to 45 minutes, and I really don't want to subject you to all of that. I will say, though, that it is an honor to be recognized with Poder Popular and with Diego. And I see a number of friends here in the room. Let us just say that we are here because we believe in our community, we believe in the city, we believe in education and the development of our youth. And I would like to ask our members of FOSPL to please stand so they can be recognized. If you do not stand, I will point you out. That goes for you folks over here as well. I can see that there's some members who've decided to be shy, but okay.
Ken, and we'd like to have all the members come forward, please, and let the council recognize you.
Thank you, council members. We will now go to a presentation by the Monterey Bay National Marine Sanctuary. This was originally requested by Councilmember McShane, so we will receive a presentation from Paul Michael, the sanctuary superintendent.
If I may, Mr. Mayor, I'm thrilled by this opportunity. The sanctuary being as close as it is, I recently was appointed as an alternate to the Marine Sanctuary, and I've learned so much about how important the ocean resources are to the Salinas Valley, being as close as we are, and the agricultural industry and community and the valley ecosystem tied as close as it is to the ocean. Paul Michel comes with decades of environmental management experience at the local, state, federal, and international level. He is no new body to the marine sanctuary system. He has been here since 2007 and served the Cal EPA, the national EPA, and LA, San Francisco. You've got a heck of a reputation and a great attitude. It's just a pleasure to work with you, and I think we're lucky to have you tonight here in Salinas, so thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you, Councilmember McShane and Mayor Gunter, council members and friends. Thanks so much for the opportunity to talk about my favorite subject, is the Marine Sanctuary. This Marine Sanctuary is one of only 13 here in the United States. These are the United States' crown jewels of the ocean, from American Samoa to Massachusetts to Florida to Olympic Coast to the Great Lakes. These are the jewels of our national marine sanctuary program, much like national parks or national forests. We're chartered with understanding and protecting this unique ecosystem here on the Central Coast. We have a sanctuary advisory council, as Councilmember McShane mentioned, that meets 5 times a year. We usually do one of those meetings here in Salinas, so I invite you to come to one of those meetings there. As as Steve can attest, they're quite entertaining, just like many council members' meetings are. So and invite you to come. I don't have a whole lot of time, but I'm going to try to buzz through this really quickly. The sanctuary is actually a really large area. It is the nation's second largest marine sanctuary at over 6,000 square miles, 275 miles of California coast. You know, we have 5 coastal counties, 12 coastal cities, 6 congressional districts. I've probably heard from all of those at least once. And we have this amazing economic vibrancy here, as you know, on the Central Coast, this synergy of agriculture and hospitality and tourism and recreation and higher education, and this connection to the marine environment with its ocean science. This is a world-renowned center for ocean science policy and management. It really makes this place really special. And for anybody who's been out or near the bay or anywhere along the coast here, you know what a phenomenal place it is. This is kind of what we call the Serengeti of the sea. There's no place like it anywhere where you can get this close to giant marine mammals like elephant seals and whales. And it is a tourist hotspot, as you know. We have 94 different species of marine birds. We have 33 different species of marine mammals. The whales, the seals, the porpoises and dolphins, some of the charismatic megafauna, and thousands of species of marine algae for you marine algae buffs. So we've really got it all going on here on the Central Coast of California. It is truly spectacular. What I also wanted to talk about, what I think might really resonate with you, is I pulled some numbers from our ocean economics program that really speaks to the strength of our coastal ocean sanctuary economy. I was invited just recently to speak at this Branding the Monterey Bay Region conference that Congressman Farr puts on. And we're really trying to talk about how we brand this region with this coast and ocean and agriculture and hospitality tourism component. So I pulled some numbers about what is the vibrancy of our economy here. And so it should be no surprise to you that we have nearly a $7 billion coastal tourism economy here in the 5 coastal counties on the Central Coast, really dependent upon a clean, healthy, and accessible ocean. I mean, Santa Cruz alone has 4 million visitors to the beach boardwalk area. You know, the Carmel, 2 million, and at least that many in Monterey to Cannery Row and the aquarium, just to give you a few examples. And no surprise to Salinas, and upwards of $6 billion ag economy here in the Salinas Valley. It's just truly remarkable. I can't think of any other place on the planet that has this closeness of marine sanctuary, of a special marine environment with this vibrant ag economy. It's truly something special, as you know. Also here on the Monterey Bay region, it's known for its marine research. There's about 25 marine science institutions that are doing work here on the Central Coast. We have the environmental and educational facilities like the Monterey Bay Aquarium, the Seymour Center, with millions of visitors there. And the sanctuary, while we don't regulate fishing, we help provide this important and high-quality marine ecosystem that supports a $20 million a year annual commercial fishing industry. We've been developing some pretty cool tools to help outreach and explain and inform and inspire people about the ocean and what we have in this marine sanctuary. You know, sanctuaries have only been around, this sanctuary, only 20 years. So we have a little bit of national park envy. You know, some of these parks like Yosemite and Yellowstone, they've been around for a long time and people really know what they are. A lot of times when I tell people I work for the sanctuary, they're like, what? What's that? Is that a church or is that the aquarium? Like, so we have this huge challenge to try to tell people who we are and what we do. So we've been developing some pretty cool tools to help do that. One of those is available for free. It's a free download on your iPhones. You can simply go to SeaPhoto, and you can download this really neat app that has all the commonly found flora and fauna, so plants and animals that you find in the marine sanctuary, with other cool links. We've been developing some really interesting interactive maps where you can do virtual tours of the underwater world and things like that. It's available through our website. One of the most exciting things that we've done recently is we've opened a state-of-the-art Gold LEED certified visitor center in Santa Cruz. This is at the base of the beach boardwalk, so we're getting a lot of visitation there from those that go to the beach boardwalk area. It is a 12,000 square foot visitor center that's got amazing exhibits, and I invite you all to come and explore for yourself. It is truly amazing. We opened the doors last July. We've had about 60,000 visitors come through already, so we even haven't even had a whole summer yet of visitation, but we anticipate greeting about 200 to 250,000 people a year as we ramp up operations of this visitor center. So it's a great opportunity. We want to do events there. If you want to do community events or outreach or receptions, that's a wonderful facility to do those kinds of things there. So it's a community asset that we would like to share. Another interesting thing that we've done to help get the word out about who we are, what we do, is that we've developed a television show. And so we've partnered with Access Monterey Peninsula to develop what we call Your Sanctuary TV. And we've produced about 9 episodes of this show, but we have over 100 programs now that's available under yoursanctuarytv.org, which we will launch on June 8th, which is World Oceans Day. And this is a great opportunity to talk about, you know, this amazing place and our stewardship responsibilities. And we bring in content and information and exciting video from all over the country and all over the world into this show. And it's a 30-minute magazine-style format, so it moves quickly. It's not one of these sleepy shows where people are just talking. It's pretty fast-moving and exciting. And if you've got a connection to the sanctuary and to the ocean, we want to hear about it. We want to put you on the show. So we're in over 80 cities now across the United States with this show on local access television. And we think we're going to get to about 150, 200 channels by the end of the summer. So it's a great opportunity to connect and show how we're all connected to the marine environment. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about, well, what are we doing specifically in Salinas? What might be of interest to you? Well, starting this summer with the Resource Conservation District of Monterey County and the Central Coast Wetlands Group, we're going to be working to improve water quality in the Santa Rita Creek watershed. So we're going to work with upstream growers to reduce pollutant inputs and do restoration work and community outreach. And so we have this, what we call our Ag Water Quality Alliance, and we are partnering with agriculture, with stakeholders to try to improve water quality that we know ends up in our marine sanctuary. We're doing some things in other watersheds, but particularly with partners in the Lower Gabilon watershed. We're holding stakeholder meetings there with growers, with local government, with conservation groups, and technical service providers to identify conflicts and hurdles in trying to overcome some of the more severe water quality problems there. We just held our annual snapshot day. It's a volunteer monitoring event. This is our 14th year where we go out and we sample water quality in hundreds of creeks up and down the Central Coast. There's about 15 sites here in the Salinas area. So now we have 14 years of water quality data here in the Salinas area that you might find very interesting to see what kinds of trends we're seeing in water quality here locally. I'd be happy to share that with you. And a big ticket item that we're really excited about is that we just kicked off the start of a $125 million irrigation nutrient management plan for the Salinas Valley. So our own sanctuary ag coordinator is going to be working with and facilitating this and managing this grant, working with the Resource Conservation District and others to conduct assessments and work in this watershed and the whole Salinas Valley to improve water quality, to encourage best management practices, monitor water quality, and report on our successes. So a lot of great stuff going on here. I'd love to do maybe a study session with you sometime to tell you more about these and other great projects and opportunities for us to do more here in Salinas. The last thing I want to leave you with is that we're doing a photo fishing contest this summer. We're launching June 8th. It's called the Sanctuary Classic. And what we want to do is we want to try to encourage kids to go out and go fishing in the sanctuary. And it's not about the biggest or most fish you catch. It's about the photos that you take while you're out on the bay. So whether you're catching fish or whether you're just out having fun, we want to get those photographs. And then like on Facebook, what you do is you go online and you put your photo online and get your friends and family and others to vote for your picture. And if your photo wins that week, you get a $100 gift certificate from West Marine. And at the end of the summer, there are $4,000 scholarships that are given out to kids. So it's for kids under 18 and all of us who think we're under 18 to go out on the bay and have a great time fishing. So this runs all summer long. Get out and enjoy the sanctuary and fish. And with that, I have a really cool poster map of the sanctuary I'd like to present Mayor Gunter, and I'll leave it with the city clerk. So thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you. Well, now you're going to be privileged to know that they're going to ask you questions.
Oh, great. Okay.
So we're going to start down on my right. Is there any questions on my right? Councilmember Barrera. Councilwoman De La Rosa. Councilwoman Lutz has a question.
Okay, great.
You know, this is a really interesting and it's very eye-opening. And I enjoyed what you said. There's no place anywhere like it. And I appreciated that comment because we really have a very delicate balance of environments here. And certainly with Salinas being the largest metropolitan area between San Jose and somewhere in Southern California, we really must have a big impact on the Bay and its health. So my question is, especially I'm looking at some of the things that the lower Gavilan watershed, the Santa Rita Creek drainage, what are you doing with, or what is your concern about plastic bags? I know the county is looking at passing a plastic bag ban or really, really in the process of doing it. There's a number of cities on the coast that have plastic bag bans. We're looking at it here in Salinas. Can you talk a little bit about what that impact is? And
sure.
Is that an issue?
I'm so glad that you mentioned that, because Save Our Shores and Laura Casa would have killed me if I didn't mention that the sanctuary has supported the plastic ban bag up and down the Central Coast and for all of California. Marine debris is a huge issue. The beach cleanups, have tons of trash that we pick up annually. And when we go out and we do research in the sanctuary and we're towing a camera sled underwater, we see so much garbage out there, plastic bags, you name it, we see it. And it is a real tragedy. And so part of it is a public education and outreach effort, and a lot of it's just cleanup effort. But anything that we can do to reduce the amounts of trash that is getting into the system, ending up in the ocean, is worth doing. When you see leatherback turtles, for example, that are choking on plastic bags, these are animals that travel the Pacific, and so they're picking up trash wherever, but we know there's a lot of trash that ends up in the Monterey Bay. And so I'm so glad you mentioned that, because it's really important. There's all these ubiquitous toxic issues with runoff, but trash is something that we can really get our hands around and try to directly influence.
So as the county moves forward and we move forward, I'm assuming that we'll use you as a resource and you'll be ready and able to help us as we're putting together an ordinance.
You can count on it.
And I really like this brochure. Monterey Bay begins on your street. This is a great brochure because I think it really brings home to all of us how close we are to the ocean.
Thank you.
Do you think you can add some pictures to the consequences to our decisions on the plastic that ends up in the oceans so that we can have a more vivid image of what you're talking about? Because if we don't see what's going on, how do we understand the consequences?
So the comment is about providing more visual aids to better understand what we see in the marine environment with regard to trash. And I would invite you to visit our website, and specifically the Simon part of our website, which has thousands of photographs that are free to use and download. But also Save Our Shores has really a focus on that, and they have tremendous photos that document that. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman, to my left, any questions?
So my question ties into kind of the farmers versus the environmentalists when it comes to water quality issues. I think this last year or so, there's just been a lot of energy there and a lot of people digging their feet in the sand, so to speak. My question to you is, where do you see trends in water quality management, certainly as it relates to our marine resources? And how do you see the solution? do you see the trend ultimately that folks are ultimately responsible for what comes off their farm ground, and how can we play a role in that? Certainly when it comes to much of the processing in our city, that's the bread and butter to our industry here, vegetable processing. And
right. That is such a great question, and one that's loaded. I don't like to look at it as farmers versus environmentalists, because I believe we all care deeply about water quality in our environment. And that's certainly what I hear when I talk to farmers and environmental groups. And we all sort of own the problem, and we own the potential solutions, because we all eat, the food that's grown here, and we all believe in this amazing place and want it for our children and grandchildren. So I think the trends you're going to see is for more requirements, but also more cooperation. And that's really what the sanctuary is here for, is to facilitate that cooperation, to encourage best management practices, to be that bridge, be a bridge builder between the regulated industry and the environmental groups, and working hand in hand with the regulators to really make sense of it all, to make it doable. That is our goal. And I think that through the Water Quality Alliance, and help with getting grant money. We've been very successful in getting state and federal grant money directed to Salinas Valley, to work on this problem. So we need your help to write letters of support or things like that. I'll be coming to Salinas to get those letters of support so we can get the money needed to do the work here, because the desire is here to work on this problem.
Thank you.
I have a question. Are you getting grants or are you doing community outreach? Because I agree with the gentleman. The community needs to know how it's affecting the sanctuary, or, you know, our oceans and the mammals and everybody else, the fish. So are you doing that?
We are, and I think we can do a lot more. The public education outreach is not an endpoint. It's a continual process.
Right.
And we need to do a lot more of that. So I will charge our ag team to do more of that here in Salinas. Like other federal agencies right now, we're really having a tough time, but this is where we get big bang for the buck, is when we do education outreach. It's about relationships, and it's about changing behavior, and that takes footwork, that takes legwork, and there's no magic bullet, but it's about doing more in this community and getting the word out, so thank you for that.
Mm-hmm. And does this come in Spanish?
I believe it does, yes.
Oh, okay. If you could leave us some.
Yes, we have some outside.
Okay,
on the
great.
Table.
And I would also suggest that, you know, you work with the schools.
Yeah.
It starts with the children.
Yeah, we do. We had for many years a program called Marito that was focused on Spanish language in our schools. And unfortunately, due to budget cuts, we haven't been able to keep that. But many of the schools here have continued with the curriculum. So the teachers that went through our training program are continuing to do the Marito program with kids and getting kids out to the ocean. To see it, to feel it, to taste it, to understand that we're all connected. So we'll try to keep that program going and do some more grant writing to try to get funds for that. Thank you.
Thank you. We will now go to the public for any comments. Anyone that would like to make a comment on this presentation?
Paul, great job. I would encourage you to reach out to Hartnell, Cabrillo, CSU, UC. They have service learning at the, not at the junior colleges, but at the further up, and I know that Hartnell is thinking about service learning, and use their resources and use those youngsters and educate them and get some presentations on the campuses as well as the high school, junior highs. These kids over here's age. You can never get too much education out there. That seems to be the theme here today, is education. That's what I would encourage. Reach out. And I'm sorry that you closed it at 18, the scholarship. I was hoping I could get in on that.
Thank you. Yeah, we've been working with the universities and specifically Hartnell, but we can always do more. Thank you.
Is there anyone else that would like to make a comment to the city council regarding this, please?
My name is Mark Powell. I just would like to get with you probably right after the meeting and also say, hey, I can take personal responsibility for some of the decisions I make, and that's where it probably starts. And same thing, I have a business, I could probably throw up a couple links, throw a couple more stuff up, so can we please get together after? And I know I can take personal responsibility for the decisions I make on a daily basis, and I think that's where it probably starts with all of us, you know, picking up a little bit of trash here and there, and that could be a very easy, free thing to do.
Absolutely.
With no grant money needed.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else from the public? Seeing none, we're going back to the council members for comments at this time. Councilmember McShane.
Yeah, I just want to say thanks. I think this is the first time that the sanctuary has been before the council. I think I'm the first dude from Salinas that served as an alternate to the council. And I just have realized over the last year or so that there's a tremendous connection. We are a coastal community, and we're probably the greatest influencer on the local coastal economy and ultimately quality of the coastal community within 100 miles or more. You know, I'm actually pretty energized about learning more of the plastic bag ban. I've kind of become a believer in really addressing that head on. I've shared that with Councilwoman Lutz and some of the other advocates for that. We got a lot of work to do. This is only the tip of the iceberg, and I hope that you can count on Salinas for letters of support and that we can be an advocate for one of our greatest resources and build those bridges with agriculture. Thank you.
Councilmember Castaneda.
Thank you, Mayor. For myself, I missed your presentations. My apologies to that. But anything to do with the service learning community, one of the speakers mentioned that. I'm very close-knit to the education committee, community here in the city. So more with the learning factors, anything that can be driven by myself or in support of this council, let me know. Look forward to hearing some more information and meeting up with you as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Councilwoman Lutz.
So I believe that Salinas, at least in the Salinas Carr Lake region, that part of the watershed, I think there's at least four creeks that pass through on their way to the sanctuary. So we really do have a big impact on the Marine Bay Sanctuary, and it's really important that we educate the community to talk about how valuable this resource is and what an important economic benefit it is also to our community. So even if it's kind of so-so on the environment, you at least can support the whole economic benefit. So I just wanted to thank you for coming. And as far as you asked for letters of support, we have a legislative committee. Please put your requests in. We can get those letters of support generated and out as quickly as possible so that we can help you get those bonds and those grant monies, because those grant monies impact and affect all of us for the better quality of our lives. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll go to my right, Councilwoman De La Rosa.
I just want to say thank you for doing such a great job and for saving our oceans. And again, you know, whatever we can do to do that outreach in our community, because we know that, again, education is so important. And again, because I sit on the solid waste and I see all the outreach that they're doing in the schools, you know, on recycling, and it's working. So again, we can do that education.
Councilmember Barrera.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Michelle, thank you for the presentation. I think as far as the outreach, you know, there's hundreds of people that don't even come to city council because they don't need us for anything. What they do is they just go start picking up garbage. I know Jorge Salazar way at the back. He's heavily involved in the Lower Gavilan watershed cleanup. Once a month, there's a group of individuals, 20, 30 people, very silently, they just go out and do the work. There are children right now. I know Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Academy, on North Sanborn Road, they have two strong educators, teachers, that are very active in the sanctuary, and they're educating the children. And you know, I think some of our strongest allies is our children, because they're very well educated on the subject. They know about how important it is to keep the ocean clean, and they're out and doing it. So I thank you for the outreach. I think what's awesome is the empowerment. You know, when somebody takes the initiative to say, I'm gonna go and do my part. Just the other day, I was just going out for a walk, and there was this one gentleman out by the Gavilan watershed. He just had his paper bag picking up litter, and he says, I just come and walk my dog and pick up litter when I can.
Great.
So thank you for the outreach.
Thank you.
Councilwoman Craig.
Just want to say thank you for your presentation. You know, oftentimes when we have presentations, people come and talk about their nonprofit organization or their company, and I commend you for actually giving us the Salinas-specific projects that you're going to be working on, particularly the Santa Rita Creek drainage. I know on my end of town, never in a million years, you know, would you think that your residents actually have some concern about that, but it is most definitely being talked about in some of our homeowners association meetings and community meetings. So thank you for recognizing that and certainly working to improve it. So thanks.
Thank you.
I want to thank you for your presentation this evening. I think that it's an eye-opener for everyone that how close we are to Monterey Bay. We're kind of spoiled. We can drive across the little highway and we're there, and the rest of the world has to fly in here to appreciate what we have all the time. And if we don't take care of it, as you've said, we won't have it forever. So I encourage everyone to take note of your presentation, and we look forward to future meetings. Thank you.
Thank you.